I get it. I get it that the Asian community and the black community has had very sour relations in the past several decades.
To your Asian community, it's all love on this end. What y'all can do is just come be present. You know what I'm saying? Just like our white allies, we need y'all support.
Being Filipino-American, we're taught to blend in. And part of blending in is keeping your head down. And, you know, that was for the previous generation. And we had the luxury of going up here and sharing wider perspectives and just keeping our head down. So taking advantage of the privilege of not having to do that and using that privilege in a way that helps the people who need help right now, and that's black people.
You know, protesting for George Floyd, Breonna Taylor, protesting for the countless black lives that have been lost because of police brutality, because of racism, because of the violence that comes from it.
My dad's family was in the Japanese internment camp. Their rights were taken away from them and they were put in prison for being Japanese. So because of that history, it is like part of my legacy to just like continue the work that they have done. And it's just so important to be able to like tell those stories. You know, so this doesn't happen again, because history, it's like cyclical.
It takes us like working together like this all the time, not just when something like this happens. You know what I'm saying? We gotta always work together.
Yeah, it is taking like a risk. We're all like afraid, but I feel like it is really essential. Essential businesses are open. I feel like this act is like essential. So that's why I'm doing it.
All my Asian American folks out there, it's important that you speak to your families, because like they say, silence is violence, and when it's better for black people, it's better for everybody.
And if we don't like stand up and if we don't speak for ourselves and for our people, then we're not gonna progress in society.
But again, this don't mean shit if we don't come together afterwards and educate each other on how we can really get about this. This will all be for nothing. We'll just go back to working our 9-to-5 jobs and just be sitting complacent about where we are in America and the world.